Thank God.
Dr. Nutt presents your Boone's Creek Opry. Welcome to the Dr. Nuff Boone's Creek Opry. We're delighted to have you here at the Big Barn in Boone's Creek on an Easter weekend.
That's right. I'm Jukebox Jess.
And my name is Bailey George, and we're delighted to have you here for a wonderful evening of music. We always like to start out our Boone's Creek Opry with a prayer and a bit of history.
To do that, let's make welcome Reverend Jack Cotton Oates to the stage.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, everybody. Good to see everybody tonight. We're going to have some fun. This history moment. One of the jobs of the Boone's Creek Historical Trust is to be sure you know a little bit about the history of this area. What the trust does is preserves artifacts and documents and all kinds of things that have to do with the culture of this particular area here. Well, an important part of our culture is what? What you're here for tonight? Music. What you're here for tonight? Our country music. So we've been on a little streak here presenting some news and history about some of the music that we listen to here on Saturday nights and some of the artists that have over the years brought it. And because gospel music, gospel is an important part of our music, I've been looking for those musicians who knew the Lord. And even though they struggled, and probably because they struggled, the Lord found them and they found the Lord. One of those tonight is Glenn Campbell. And I'll tell you something about Glenn tonight. By the time Glenn Campbell won his sixth Grammy Award in 2014 for his final recording, he was dying of Alzheimer's, I'm Not Gonna Miss You is what he played. He'd won almost every award and achieved every milestone available to musicians. One of the best-selling solo male artists in history, U.S. history, Campbell released more than 70 albums, selling 50 million copies, and charting more than 80 songs. A member of the Country Music Hall of Fame and the Musicians Hall of Fame, he won the Country Music Association's Entertainer of the Year, twice won the Academy of Country Music's Album of the Year Award, and was named Male Vocalist of the Year by both. In 2012, he was awarded the Grammy's most prestigious honor, a Lifetime Achievement Award. He is best known for hit songs like Rhinestone Cowboy, By the Time I Get to Phoenix, Try a Little Kindness, Gentle on My Mind, Wichita Lineman, Southern Nights, and Galveston. Campbell grew up loving country music. He made music that connected with Americans from rural farms to modern cities. He brought his love for country music to new fans who helped move what was once a regional sound onto the national stage, sparking the interest of an enthusiastic international audience in all things country. Although many of Campbell's biggest hits weren't explicitly Christian, Campbell did record an album of his favorite hymns. In a Cross Rhythms interview, Campbell said, "I love singing gospel music and hymns. Being a Christian, I love to tell people about Christ and what he's done for me and can do for them." No More Night is one of the gospel songs we love that he sang. The 12th child and seventh son of a dirt-poor sharecropper, Campbell was born on April 22, 1936, in Delight, Arkansas, in the midst of the Great Depression. The family lived on a farm and barely managed to get along by growing corn, cotton, watermelons, and potatoes. "We had no electricity," he said, "and money was scarce. A dollar in those days looked as big as a saddle blanket. Even though Daddy and Mama got us to church regularly, I had never been baptized. So in December of 1981, about a year before we were married, Kim and I flew to Arkansas, where I asked my brother, Lindell, a Church of Christ preacher, to baptize us. But being a Christian doesn't mean a person will never make mistakes. On the contrary, Campbell's problems with drugs and alcohol are well known. He also walked a difficult road in his relationships. He was married four times. Nevertheless, his Christian faith was evident in a number of interviews he gave during his lengthy career. He was often willing to admit his faults and speak about past mistakes, as well as give glory to God for the privileged life that he led. In a Guidepost interview, Campbell says, "In August of 1986, I was in Hawaii for concerts with the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. After one of the shows, I went out for drinks with friends. I don't know that I had any more to drink than usual, but the next morning I awoke with just about the worst hangover of my life. The sun was streaming through the curtains, and it was all I could do to roll out of bed and get on my knees. Lord, I prayed, get me off this stuff. Help me find a way. This time I wanted to surrender everything to Christ, my pain, my drinking, my whole life. Again, I don't know, understand the mystery of why he chose that moment to save me, but he reached into my life and took up the burden. When God lifted my obsession for alcohol, it was as if he had raised the curtain on a whole new life. He changed me in ways I could never have changed myself, and that's the key. Today, I truly have a peace that passes all understanding. I really don't understand it, but I thank the Lord all the time. I'm a man richly blessed despite myself." In an interview with Cross Rhythms in 1990, Campbell said, "I've been extremely successful in my career. And what's more, I've been blessed with a wonderful family and friends. But I know it wouldn't have happened if the good Lord had not wanted it to. I'm very grateful for all that I have and want to give the Lord the thanks that he deserves. I was never happier than when I was with my daddy. Daddy's been dead a while now, but I feel as if I found a father again. He's in heaven, and I'm his boy." What a sweet story. Yeah. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we're in the midst of celebrating the wonderful gift that your Son gave us by dying on a cross in our place. We lift up our hearts and our thanks to you. He had to do that because we're so lost, Lord. Just like Glenn, we struggle with so many things. We're far from perfect. That's why you came. You came to save us. And we're thankful, Lord, for everyone who acknowledges that they need saving and acknowledging that the Lord Jesus is the Savior and reaches out to him and trusts him, that person can have a new life. And I pray here tonight, Lord, that if anyone here has never found Jesus, that they'd find him in their hearts, even tonight. And so tomorrow we can celebrate together the fact that he's not dead, he's living. And he's with us, and we're so thankful for that. And so, Lord, tonight we give you thanks for all the gospel music that continues to witness to what he did so long ago. And we pray that as we hear that music, that our hearts will be lifted to him, and our ties with him by faith will be strengthened. And we ask all of this in his name and for his sake. Amen.
Thank you. We'd like to thank some of the people that make our Boone's Creek Opry possible. Of course, we'd like to thank our presenting sponsor of Dr. Nuff. Let's give them a big hand.
Celebrating 75 years, enough is indeed enough.
That's right. And we also like to thank Tim Hicks Construction.
Kelly and Jennifer Wolf.
Eastman Credit Union.
And Derek Paduk of Woodsman Insurance.
Thank you for everything you do. That's right. Let's give all of our sponsors a big round of applause, because they make it possible to do what we're doing here tonight. Well, as we get into the music here and into the Easter season, we thought we'd do one of the songs of the season. This is a song that was originally done by Cowboy Copas around 1949. The Stanley Brothers also did it, and Ralph did it solo too. But we hope you enjoy us doing it, one called The Scarlet Purple Robe. It's a story so unkind, in the holy book we find how he stood alone, forsaken on that day. False accused and e'er condemned, yet they found no fault with him, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. Purple robe my Savior wore, oh, the shame for me he bore as he stood alone, forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red, the man who wore for the scarlet purple robe. The truth when they're proclaimed from the lips of Pilate came. In this man I find no reason he should die. But the multitude then cried, let him now be crucified, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. Purple robe my Savior wore, oh the shame for me he bore, as he stood alone, forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. Shame for me he bore, as he stood alone, forsaken on that day. And they placed upon his head piercing thorns of bloodstained red, the man who wore the scarlet purple robe. The man who wore the scarlet purple robe.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bailey, for singing that for us. Get us in the mood for this wonderful weekend.
Well, thank you. We have a wonderful group here tonight, and we hope you're in the mood for them as well. They've been here before, and they were a big hit, so we got them back again.
Would you please help us make welcome Brian Osborne and the Ash County Boys.
Ash Mountain Boys.
Ash Mountain Boys.
Howdy. Good to be back at the Boone's Creek Opera again. I love this place over here. Love y'all. It's a good place to play. We've played here 3 times, I think, now, and we've loved it every time. Just great, great company. I come to a place where the people love it, and y'all love it.
Three men on the mountain.
We'll go back here and get you a gospel song here for Easter. This is one that we've been doing a while, one called Three Men on the Mountain.
Up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me.
Well, the man on the right was a sinner too, but he was sorry for sin. He begged the Lord's forgiveness, and Jesus said to him, fear not this earthly death. Before this day is o'er, shalt thou be with me in paradise on heaven's golden shore.
There were 3 men on the mountain, up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Up on Calvary,
you. I'll go ahead right now and let you guys know who these folks is up here working with me.
Oh, he knows us.
He knows us.
Well.
I should. We work a lot together. If I don't know this bunch by now, I might as well just give it up and quit. Put the guitar in the bed.
Did you get your cue card back
Yeah.
Here?
He ain't got them. He ain't got them. I need them. Over here playing the banjo, I'm going to start with you. He said he didn't care. Well, I'm going to tell him all kinds of stuff about you, can't you? Nah, this man here, he's been very good to me and picked with me for about 4 years now, ain't he? Five.
How long?
4 years?
20 years or so.
4 years,
long, hard years,
I guess.
Later.
Nah, he's my good inspiration. He's the best preacher you ever sit down and listen to. If y'all want to listen to a good preacher, get on Grocers Creek Baptist Church some more. He's the best, in my book. One of the greatest. And I ain't saying that just because you're my friend. I'm telling you, he's good. But good banjo picker, one of the best baritone singers I've ever sung with. And he does great. Mr. George Jesse from Lebanon, Virginia. Who's next? J.M. Biggin? Mr. Biggin back here. We call him Biggin.
You better.
I call him something else, but I ain't going to. Nah. This is my buddy here. We spend about 90% together all the time, though, riding around.
We love to hate each other and hate the love.
That's right. Me and him, we're mowing partners. We've been working on lawnmowers here for the past 2 or 3 weeks. About drove us crazy. I ain't had no sleep, go work all day my regular job, and then go work on lawnmowers all night long. Then have to go play music on the weekends.
Hush that whining, get on with it. Hurry up. We got
back here, one of the best bass singers, lead singers. I used to play bass, but I gave it up. He stole all my stuff, so I just retired from bass playing.
Thank you.
He does a mighty fine job. Mr. J.M. Trevor from Boone, North Carolina. Biggin. Call him Biggin when you see him around. That's his nickname. Better come up with some kind of nickname. And this is Rev. I always call him Rev. So. And down here playing the fiddle. Good fiddle player. He's a good mandolin player. Also good singer. Good tenor singer. Lead, baritone, whatever you need. Oh, Eric can do it. From Gate City, Virginia, Mr. Eric McMurray. McMurray. I got it right. And here playing the mandolin's one of the few Bill Monroe-style mandolin players left around. There ain't many of these left, and I hate it because it's my favorite. But he's a good tenor singer also, lead singer, good friend. Does great. He's been pretty loyal to me, too, about picking gigs and stuff. But Mr. Greg Blevins from Marion, Virginia.
What next?
Thank you. came into the room where she met a final doom, and I ain't gonna be treated this old way. This old way. Give me trouble all my life. Let me out in the cold rain and snow. Rain and snow. Let me out in the cold rain and snow. Here's an old song that there's a write-up on this song here about a month ago in the Bluegrass Sun Unlimited that a lady I know, her daddy wrote this song. And
you know her, really?
Yeah, Vivian Hopkins.
Well.
Her daddy wrote this, Ralph Bennington.
Oh, yeah, I remember him.
Anyway, we run into her down at the festival. What is it, Asheville we run into her, wasn't it?
Yeah, down at Bluegrass. Yeah,
we went to Bluegrass one. First Class back in February when we run into her down there, and I sat and jick-jacked for a little while and visited. Well, I hadn't seen her in 25 years, probably.
He's good at talking.
But anyway, here's one called Cabin in Caroline. There's a cabin in the pine.
Thank you. my wife and the little that we love in a cabin in the hills of Caroline.
Get Eric over here to fill in a good number here. This is one written, I guess, by Louisville, Kentucky. I don't know.
I guess so.
Part of the Bluegrass State. This one called Louisville Breakdown.
Well, while Brian's changing chords here, it takes him longer because he's a guitar player. He thinks slower. But he's the man that does most of the bookings, and he does most of the talking most of the time. He does all the driving all the time. He's kind of a control freak, just to be honest with you. But... He was born and raised over on the edge of Ashe County, North Carolina, which is right over the hill from where I live in Watauga County. But
don't tell nobody that.
Well, you know, we've talked a lot about our family history, and the one thing we found in common was that his mother and my mother were both mothers. That's the one thing that we found in common, but we have a lot of fun with Brian, and if you'd make him welcome, that's Mr. Brian Osborne.
Thank you.
Here's an old Bill Monroe number we've been doing, one of my favorites. That's one called I'm On My Way Back to the Old Home. You gonna kick it, Eric, again?
Yeah.
Kick it.
Go ahead, there.
Yeah,
I may not be in good tune.
Well, back in the days of my childhood, in the evening when everything was still, I used to listen to the boxing. My dad
good.
My mind's blank every day. Ain't no excuse.
I know.
We'll try that. We'll feature Greg here on a mandolin tune. I've got a, I will say this much, I do have a new record coming up. I can never get it done. We did lay down the majority of the... But I do have a new record coming out. Hopefully it'll be done here in the next maybe month or so, as quick as we get over there and lay some more stuff down. I'm going to try to get it done. And maybe next time I come, I'll have it and y'all can get you a copy of it. It's going to have some good stuff. And we're, a lot of this stuff we're doing now is going to be on it. That the rainy snow is going to be on it. And But here's one that we can feature Greg on. One come hither to go yonder. Stanley Brothers and song we'll go back to here. Got we worked up and
who,
that's right. Who? One call, I think I'll just go away.
That way go? It makes no difference.
Oh yeah.
The plans we may have gone astray.
driving to.
B.
B.
I done messed up her sign here after acting crazy. It'll be all right, though, I guess. We'll straighten it back out. Here's one we got off a friend of ours that we worked up, and it's going to be on my new record, too, so. One called Your Love Is Way Up On The Mountain.
My love or your love? My love?
Something like
that.
Got to wait on these contrary banjo players, I tell you. I'm gonna give him a pay degrade, what I'm gonna do.
All right, I'm ready, here we go. That me and Eric and George have worked up. It's one of my favorite country gentleman songs. And we used to listen to this thing when I was a kid, and I thought, man, I want to learn how to do that. So we figured it out. But this is one called Little Bessie. Hey, George, you kick it out. Okay. This song was actually in the hymnal many, many years ago, and it's about a little girl who got sick, and there was no medical facilities much in that day. And she died and wound up in the arms of Jesus. It's called Little Bessie.
Hug me closer, mother, closer. Put your arms. dear mother, like a stone upon my breast. And I wonder, mother, wonder, why it is I cannot rest. Just before the lamps were lighted, just before the children came, while the room was very quiet, I heard someone call my name. Silence coming deep, lying on her mother's bosom, little Bessie fell
an old gospel song. Here's in the hymn book, one called The Prayer Bells of Heaven.
Who's doing what on this?
Whatever. You sing the lead and your little baritone, bass, whoever wants to catch your bass.
Yeah. Okay.
Jump in here. That's jump in and hang on.
Here we go.
Prayer bell. Ba-dun-dun-dun-dun. Let's see. I got to remember how it goes.
Okay, here we go.
While we are living in this world of care, many the burden that we have to bear. But there's a prayer bell that the Lord's right hand, give it a ring and he will understand.
Prayer bells of heaven, Lord, how sweetly they ring, bearing the message of the Jesus our King. When you are burdened down with troubles and care, ring on and on, for God will answer your prayer.
Three Hebrew children to the flames were thrown, because a mortal came they would not harm. Jesus delivered and then came and saw, prayer bells of heaven beats a man made law.
Prayer bells of heaven, Lord, how sweetly they ring, bearing the message of Jesus our King.
Oh,
when you are burdened down with trouble and care. Ring on and on, for God will answer your prayer. When Paul and Silas both were thrown in jail, they did not worry who would go their bail. But on the prayer bell they began to ring, off the stocks and they began to sing.
Prayer bells of heaven, Lord, how sweetly they ring. They're in the message unto Jesus our King. Oh, glory, when you are worthy.
That's Brian Osborne and the Ash Mountain Boys, everybody. Told you they was good.
We hope you'll come back again. Well, we really appreciate everybody coming out tonight. Everyone who's tuning in on YouTube, feel free to tell us where you're watching from.
That's right. And we had a request to do this song before we came out here. This is a local Charlie Bowman song. He wrote some big ones there, and he played the fiddle, and I'm not going to play the fiddle, and I'm going to play the mandolin, but anyway, this is one called Roll On Buddy, Roll On. One, two, three. I'm headed for that East Cairo. I'm headed for that East Cairo. I'm going to the land that I love. Roll on, buddy, roll on. Roll on, buddy, roll on. You know what I know, you wouldn't roll so slow. It's roll on, buddy, roll on. Sunny Tennessee, that's where I long to be. Oh, way down in sunny Tennessee. Roll on, buddy, roll on. Roll on, buddy, roll on. You know what I know, it wouldn't roll so slow. It's roll on, buddy, roll on.
Thank you. After this portion of the show, we're going to have an open mic like we always do. So stick around while we reset the stage. And there's lots of great people signed up as always. And I think there might still be time to sign up if you want to do the open mic.
That's right. Well, yeah, it's pretty full. It's better than I thought it was. Anyway, I'd like to thank Brian Osborne and the Ash Mountain Boys
so
for coming out again tonight.
You did such a good job. And you know, we're celebrating Easter weekend, so
yes.
Thank you for being with us.
We hope you have a good Easter weekend, and we'll see you next week. My name is Bailey George.
And I'm Jukebox Jess.
And we'll see you right here at the Dr. F. Boone's Creek Opera. Stick around for our open mic in just a few minutes.
All right, everybody, it's time for open mic. Let's go.
This is the time of the show where the open mic starts up. Have any of y'all ever been to the open mic before? Yes. Good. Well, there's a lot of talents around here. And everyone gets to do 3 songs or 15 minutes. And Vicki and Heather are usually here for this portion, but I'm going to, we're going to do this on their behalf as well. Make y'all welcome to the open mic. And the first act tonight is the Band Joneses. Make them welcome.
Hey, thanks, guys. Okay. The honest truth is you're our practice because we're playing in church tomorrow, and so this is our warm-up. Or they're our warm-down, cool-down, I don't know. He might cry. Okay, the first song we're going to do is, who did Vicki give us this one?
Mm-hmm.
It's called I Surrender All.
This is dedicated to Miss Vicki. Love you, Miss Vicki.
Okay. How fast? This morning we had a brunch, and at that brunch I had one biscuit. This song asks, how many biscuits can you eat? This is done by our youngest two girls in Summer.
Oh, good catch.
Little guy.
Do you want to start out?
Okay. It's in How does it go, bass player? You ready? Oh, you gotta sing. So much. He might stay up here all night. So in the next song, we brought in a ringer. Is he throwing these? You know, you got to teach them stage presence when they're young, so they can be their whole selves, you know. If you stand up here, you're gonna go with mom.
What's up, everyone?
Let's raise that mic up a little bit for you guys, okay?
Okay. I met Jacob because we go to the same church, and he plays the clawhammer banjo, and I play the fiddle, so naturally we gravitated towards one another. Oh, hey. There's some other church people. And tomorrow we're going to be playing, like Jacob said, we're going to be playing in church, and we're going to be playing this song. It's about the resurrection. It's called Christ the Lord is Risen Today.
Is it up?
And I think some of you might recognize this one.
Can't let me get it higher.
Actually, that's...
The sound guy was telling us.
That's good.
All right. And if you want an encore, we're down on Mayflower Road, I think. 10:30?
10:30, that's okay. Right.
Johnson City, so... Tomorrow, obviously. Okay. Not playing how many biscuits anymore. Let's see. How fast is it?
Thank you.
Thank you. It's nice when you have a pro that can come play with you.
Thank you, Nate and Jacob. Next up, we have Emily Ward. Emily had to fight through all the traffic getting out the front door. All the youngins are heading out. Got to be up early for sunrise service in the morning.
Coming up next, would you please help us make welcome Emily Ward?
I'm Emily. This is my first time playing here. I'm a beginner on the guitar. I've been a beginner for many years, so bear with me. The first one I want to do, it's half original, half a hymn, 'Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus. So I'll start with that one. Well, I don't know what lies ahead, but I'm trusting in your promises. Oh, give me faith in what's unseen and hope in what you plan for me. And hope in what you plan for me. No matter what the circumstances. This next song is a Ralph Stanley song. I've never played it in public before, so I hope it goes well. It's called Two Coats. Two coats were before me, an old and a new. I asked my sweet master, oh, what must I do? The first coat was ugly, so tattered and torn. The other, a new coat, had never been worn. I tell you the best thing I ever did do, I took off the old coat and put on the new. The first man was earthly, he came from the ground. We all bore his image the whole earth around. The next was my Savior from heaven so fair. He gave me this new coat you now see me wear. I tell you the best thing I ever did do, I took off the old coat and put on the new. I tell you the best thing I ever did do, I took off the old coat and put on the new. Now this coat, it suits me and keeps me so warm. It's good in the winter and it's good in the storm. My Jesus, he clothed me in a garment so rare. With his blood he bought me this coat I now wear. I tell you the best thing I ever did do, I took off this old coat and put on the new. I tell you the best thing I ever did do, I took off the old coat and put on the new. The last one I'm going to do is just a little Victory in Jesus, so sing along if you know it. Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. And I heard about his groaning and his precious blood atoning, and I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory
decades ago, beyond the crystal sea, and about the angels singing, oh, that old redemption story. And some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior, oh, forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. And I knew it, and all my love is doing. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood.
Thank you.
Emily Ward, everybody. Come on, you next. It's all you tonight.
Yeah.
Victory in Jesus. We got any Methodists in here? Y'all remember the old Cokesbury hymnals? That was 407 in that. That's how many times we sung that. All right, Gary. It's all you tonight. Yeah, that's right.
Heather's locked my right arm, and she has the mic where I need it, and the stand, and she's not here. I've been coming a year out here, never faced this before, but what a performance by Miss Emily. I'm telling you, that was beautiful. She tried out for American Idol, made it to where, Sheila, California or New York?
New York.
New York. And they got pictures of Ryan Seacrest, and I see why now. Yeah, it'd be great. Never played without a backup band. I guess I am the backup band.
Yeah, normally we have like, what, seven, eight people up there? Just you tonight.
Well, I hate to follow that. I tell you, that was awesome. What a beautiful voice. Goodness. That was great. Always have trouble finding the songs, as everybody knows, it comes a lot out here. And I know the song I was going to do is in here. This is an old Stanley Brothers song, and I just actually worked it up a little bit. It's called I Only Exist. Well, I'll wait till he gets his fiddle.
There he is.
There we go.
Hey, run to the car right quick.
Thank you, baby. Soon dry away. exist. How much longer can I go on like this? You broke my heart and you tortured my mind. I've lost you, darling. You're long gone this time. I knew you were no good right from the start. My friends all told me you'd break my heart with your roaming and rambling. Days are through. You'll pray for a love like I had for. No, I'm not living, I only exist. How much longer can I go on like this? You broke my heart and tortured my mind. I've lost you, darling. You're long gone this time.
Thanks, baby. Let's see here. What was I going to do? I'm going to do Rank Stranger, I think. Stay. I'm gonna tell my dog. All right, here we go. I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger traveling through this world below. There's no sickness, no toil or danger in that bright world to which I go. I'm just going to see my father, going there no more to roam. I'm just going over. Just going over home. My body asleep in the old graveyard. I'll drop the cross of self-denial and enter on my great reward. I'm just going to meet my mother. Said she'd meet me when I come.
I know dark clouds will gather round me, and on my way is rough and steep. A golden fields lie just before me, where souls redeem their vigil keep. I'm just going to see my Savior. I'm just going just going over Jordan. I'm just going over home. I'm just going over home.
Thank y'all. Heather singing harmony, it's rough.
I don't know if I can get up that high.
Let's see, three, here we go. We'll do life like a mountain railway.
Yeah. About what beer is that?
Seven, three. Yeah, I've never faced this before. I am the house band. I'm glad Bailey come out and help me. Usually I just have to be a part of it.
It's different this side, ain't it?
Yeah, I've never been solo. Alright, here we go. Yep. Life is like a mountain railway with an engineer that's brave. We must make this run successful. From the cradle to the grave, watch the hills, the curves and tunnels, never falter, never fail. Every hand's upon the throttle, and your eyes upon the rail. Blessed Savior, grace stuff's hard.
Thanks, Bailey.
Yep, yep.
Well, y'all, I believe that's all she wrote for tonight, so don't forget to take your medication, all that, and y'all have a very good Easter and drive safe, okay? Good night, everybody.